I got this on April 13th, right? They had to take hair by hair, move them from the back to the front, okay? And it took like, it was like a full day procedure. A lot of people are like, oh, did it hurt? Did it hurt? No, it actually didn't hurt at all. The only thing that hurts is when they put in the needles for the anesthesia, but it's a minor thing, okay? It's not a big deal. And they give you a pill so that you'll be drowsy and sleep, and they do the whole procedure while you're sleeping. You wake up. I didn't really feel any pain afterwards. And then the doctor said in about 4.5 months, it'll start to appear normal. What's up, guys? John Anthony here from John Anthony Lifestyle. Today we're going to go over an update on my hair transplant. Okay, I had it done on April 13th of this year, of 2021. I'm currently 37 years old. I'm going to turn 38 in October. And I thought it was time to fix my receding hairline to boost sexual market value. I've also done other procedures this year, such as Botox and eye bag fillers, which I'm going to be re-upping on the eye bag fillers and on the Botox in a month or two as well. But being 37, almost 38, I routinely get guessed to be in the age between 28 and 32. Okay, I have some friends who are in their late 20s, and lots of times people think I look younger than those guys. Okay. So I'm going to go into the details of the updates. I'm going to show you what it looks like. But before we continue, if you're not yet a subscriber, please subscribe below. You can press the notification bell for new videos every single day. We just brought on a full-time video editor. He's documenting the Vegas program this weekend, the Vegas boot camp. And then he will be flying to Brazil on Tuesday. Okay, and we're renting a boat with a bunch of girls. And we're going to document that as well. It's going to be really cool. So, also, if you are looking to master the entire game and start packing your schedule out with dates, stop having to be frustrated and lonely and, you know, trying to figure this shit out, you can jump on a free 30-minute call to talk to me or someone from my team about how we can get you very good and solve all your problems with women and with dating very, very quickly in a matter of short weeks, okay? So, basically, I got this on April 13th, right? They had to take hair by hair, move them from the back to the front. Okay. And it was like a full day procedure. A lot of people are like, oh, did it hurt? Did it hurt? No, it actually didn't hurt at all. The only thing that hurts is when they put in the needles for the anesthesia, but it's a minor thing. Okay. It's not a big deal. And they give you a pill so that you'll be drowsy and sleep. And they do the whole procedure while you're sleeping. You wake up. I didn't really feel any pain afterwards. And then the doctor said in about 4.5 months, it'll start to appear normal. But it'll be fully regrown by a year. Okay, it all falls out in the beginning, and then it regrows like a baby's hair. So let's take a look here. I had it done. He measures from the bottom of your face up to here. And it's not supposed to be a straight line. The natural curve of the hair, and I just have my hair cut here, so we have this nice little, where is it here? This nice little thing going back. It's all disoriented with the camera angle. But they replaced all this hair here. Right, so now there will be no more receding hairline, and there's a permanent transplant. And then a little bit on the sides here as well. Sorry, it's fucking reversed here. A little bit on the sides here, and they also filled in a little bit here where my mustache was connecting into my beard. Okay, and kind of the stats behind that is they can remove up to like 30 or 40% of the hair density without it being noticeable. Okay, so they just take a hair every so often. It's a scientific measurable process. And they implant them one by one to the front. Okay, another modification that was made is I started taking finasteride. So the Portuguese version, finasterida. And then I also been using minoxidil. Okay, so basically each day I squirt the minoxidil, rub it in here, rub it all into my beard. That helps promote blood flow to that area and stimulates more hair growth. And then the finasteride prevents additional hair from falling out. This is a permanent implant, it's a permanent procedure, so the whole idea is that you don't want the hair to keep receding back and have this fucking missing hair in the middle, okay? So even though I did a little joke about Derek, no plates, no dates, for the record, I respect the dude. I think he's intelligent and gives a lot of good advice. I was just kind of screwing around in the shorts, showing how timid he was in the beginning. And I was just going to show that as a clip on its own, but then I ended up throwing in some fresh and fit stuff and everyone was confused. But he gives good advice on what to do regarding hair loss prevention and this and that. Okay, so now, I mean, you'll see in the videos that are coming, but it should look more and more natural as time goes on. At the year mark, coming up in April 13th of 2022, it will have become fully regrown. Okay. But I want you guys on here, especially the guys that are getting older, to start thinking about sexual market value upgrades that you can do for yourself. Okay. I put out videos about the Botox and the eye bag wrinkles. We'll pop up the thumbnail for that. I put out the video about my hair transplant. We'll pop up the thumbnail for that. Okay, I had a teeth whitening done. We'll pop up the thumbnail for that. So these are little things you can do that aren't going to break the bank. Okay, a teeth whitening, even the transplants aren't that expensive. Okay, it was a bit cheaper in Brazil than it is in the U.S. But you can do these things in staying in shape in the gym and eating right. I'm also, and I'll do a separate video about this, I also have been doing this kind of like belly massage that helps reduce your waistline, and like it gets rid of some like belly fat by like basically depressing some of the water out of your abdomen section and stuff like that. So I've had some sessions like that. So my core is more tightened up, and I do Muay Thai and lift weights in combination. So all in all, and I take a whole host of anti-aging supplements and longevity supplements, health supplements, etc. And so the health and longevity game is just another system to be optimized, just like the dating game, just like poker, just like chess. I have a big interest and will be eventually starting a second company where I go through and detail out with logical arguments, flowcharts, etc., how to get the most bang for the buck. Again, taking the most efficient, effective, optimized strategy, how to get the most bang for the buck, not just in terms of the money you spend on supplement and longevity therapies, but also in terms of what's the most practical things to bring into your lifestyle immediately that aren't going to be hard to adjust to in terms of habit, or that aren't going to cramp your style, so to speak, or have, you know, cause you to radically overhaul your diet. So I think it's really interesting to look at all those things. Anybody that's getting up into their upper 30s, you know, anywhere in your 30s basically, or higher, you should be getting your testosterone tested. Okay, I'm on supplemental testosterone. I use the gel every day. And it's through an endocrinologist. Okay, it's different than, you know, black market steroids. This is just supplemental testosterone to put you back where nature intended you to be at when you're in your late teens, early 20s. Okay, like the 600 to 900 range for testosterone. So these are things that you guys need to consider. Okay, and it's not like these are gonna be magic fixes. Like, okay, if you get Botox and you get your testosterone levels correct, you're gonna start just slaying with chicks. Okay, you still need strategy. This is just the icing on the cake. It's good to still have fundamental core game strategy to get you most of the way there, and then just polishing your SMV. A lot of guys do it backwards. They think like, oh, I'm just gonna get a rockstar SMV and then it's gonna be easy mode. And that's not the case. I get clients all the time that are tall, jacked, good looking, etc., that have single digit leg counts or even are virgins. Okay, just because a guy is good looking doesn't mean the girls are gonna come jump on his dick. Okay, it definitely helps, but you still need to understand basic strategy, okay? So I'll make separate videos on how to get your testosterone checked and change those things. And I'll make another general SMV video where I go through all the different things I've done for myself and what I recommend for different guys of different ages and stuff like that. And that will be nice for everyone, okay? So we're off to the club. I had to just get a video out so I don't miss my daily upload. We're gonna get queued out a couple weeks in advance once the video editor arrives here. He's getting here on Tuesday. And expect the production quality to go way up. He's going to have a 4K camera, and he's going to be working full time. Okay, so we're going to have a lot of really cool videos coming. Okay, thank you guys so much for supporting the channel. As always, please like, comment, and share. Ask questions. Let me know what you guys think about all this in the comments. If you're interested in the 8-week program, you can jump on a free 30-minute call with the link in the description for that. I also have product links in the description. Please like, comment, and share once more. I appreciate it. Helps the algorithm. And I will see everybody on a lot of cool videos this week. Thank you and take care. And Jay don't stand in line. I ain't never had to wait. I'm the realest in this game. I ain't never had to fake. Just take a look at the scores. I put numbers up on the boards. I'm in a section with models, and you're at the bar trying to get out of cluster of fours. Fixture, I'm a factor. I'm a boss tycoon. My dick smell like two chicks before noon.